Hi everyone, my name is Ashley, and this is my boy, Zaney Bug, and I wanted to discuss car safety today. The Center for Pet Safety has recently done a study and done some crash testing to see what the safest way to travel with your dog is. That's a big concern for me because one of my dogs is my service dog. Zane is retired, but he wanted to help with this video anyway. The Center for Pet Safety really strongly pushes their sleepy pod harnesses. Zane right now is wearing the sleepy pod sport harness. And as you can see from his expression, he's not really enjoying it. My dogs ride in the car with me, at least my service dogs, every day. So I want them to be safe, but I also want them to be comfortable. I also am not sure that this is really as safe as the Center for Pet Safety would like us to think. My main concern, you can see, this harness goes right across his back here. This is properly attached. The seatbelt goes through these two loops on the sides. So if he got jerked forward in a crash, not only would his head and neck have no support and be jerked forward and backward and all of that, a lot of pressure would be put on his spine. I agree that he wouldn't be launched off the seat, but if his back was broken, that wouldn't necessarily help us, him being on the seat. He wouldn't be a projectile, but there's lots of things that would prevent him from being a projectile. So I started looking for a better, safer option, and preferably also more comfortable, and I found the PupSaver. All right, Bug. Let's get this nasty thing off, huh? You can see Bug is a big fan of the PupSaver. He put himself right in there. He likes it. Really easy to secure him in the PupSaver. They have their own harness. I haven't gotten one yet, but I have one ordered. I'm sure it will be even easier and more comfortable since it's meant to be used with these seats. But for now, I'm just using his Herda harness. And then all you do, so there's a tether inside of here, and it just comes up around. And clips in place in the back of the harness. So now he's clipped into position. You can see he's much happier there. Aren't you, Bug? He can lay down in there if he wants. And this way, if there was a crash, this would be like a catcher's mitt. He would hit the front here. So he's sandwiched between the back cushion of the car and the nice soft PupSaver. This is the Air 25. Bug weighs 19 pounds. So he's right in that range. And you can see he thinks it's very comfortable. He much prefers this to the sleepy pod, and I prefer it too. I think that it would be much safer. There's nothing to apply pressure to any specific point of his body. There's also protection for his head and neck. And this little guy's precious cargo. We got to make sure he's safe. So that's just my opinion. I have done quite a lot of research. So you have to decide for yourself what you think is best for your pet. But this was the conclusion that I came to. For me, this is the safest, best option. There are other carrier type beds and stuff that are out there, but I wasn't impressed with anything's crash testing. I was very skeptical of the Center for Pet Safety's claims that they felt the best performing carrier was the mobile pet bed made by Sleepy Pod, when in their own videos, it clearly falls right off the seat. there's some sort of attachment or new thing that you can get to make it so that it supposedly doesn't do that. But I just don't have a lot of faith in that. I think that this performed much better. And furthermore, my dogs wouldn't fit in the mobile pet bed. They do fit in the PupSaver. And as you can see, Bug has now gone to sleep and is very happy. So I highly recommend the PupSaver. You can see I've got one in my front seat too. And I have two more coming from my back seat, so that each one of my four boys will have their own PupSaver. Thanks for watching. Hope you have safe travels.